Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living and a retirement worth having. When we do this, we're really considering not only how we make a living and how we make earnings, but we're also looking at who will we partner with and how will that partner affect our life. How that partner affects our life changes our entire life and existence. They are someone we will play with, they are someone we will stay with, they will someone we will be, hopefully, in love with. For my life, I've only had a few life partners. I had one in college for practically a short time, and that was appropriate for that time and that age and that style of life. I had one after that that I picked up overseas, and that lasted most of my adult life. We played with each other, we stayed with each other, we laid with each other, we did everything together, and openly it still didn't work out marvelously because there was always a disconnect between language and culture. But that doesn't mean we loved each other less. It actually meant we loved each other more because we had to work at a lot of things that were difficult and different for each other. But when it came to the replacing that lifetime love, that long spouse, that long wife that was in my life so long, I had to really think about what I preach to people, what I teach to people in my programs that I do in the metaphysical community and I do in the business world. That if your life partner isn't right for you, then you will not achieve the retirement that's right for you. And you will not enjoy your retirement because that life partner will always be wanting to play with other people, not just you. They will also be wanting to steal from people, not just you. So when I talk about these things, I'm talking about the genuineness of making a plan of who is right for you in the end of life. Because at some point you might get ill, at some point you might get sick, and that person will be the one responsible for feeding you, for loving you, for wiping your ass, for doing everything with a little bit of class. You have to have someone who can go to places you like to go. You have to have someone who likes the things you like to do. You have to have someone who really loves you. And a person who really loves you doesn't try to beat you to the ground. A person who loves you doesn't try to hound you and harm you. A person who loves you doesn't interfere with your relationships with your birth family or others you have throughout the year. A person who loves you really knows what you need. A person who loves you really knows and listens with heed. A person who loves you truly knows your soul. A person who loves you marks you as the most important person of all.